You have my thanks. Ah, here it is. In this scene, the main character says, "That ass better not crack under pressure." Usually, people's asses are already cracked. Yours is as well, right? I understand. But please tell me someday. For now, I will put the question on hold. Currently, this is the only section that I am unclear on. But I suspect that if I continue reading, I will encounter even more confusing phrases. If you don't mind, could I ask you to read with me until the end? Thank you very much. With your help, I've been able to update my records with new information. Apparently, this book has a sequel. If it is possible, I would like to read with you again sometime. It's gotten rather late. We should head back to our rooms. Or, should I say, our turfs. Excuse me.
So dance, if you wanna go ahead. Free to do whatever, I'm chilling on my bed. I'm out in my biz, so mind your own biz. Whatever like is, we gon' throw it to set. Hey, 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 feeling the fire with the burning desire. Every day we aspire, but never
yes.
Expires. But we gon' chill today, let me rock the world tomorrow.
That reminds me. I was reading this book during class once. One of our classmates saw and said to me, "Wow, I'm surprised. So, you're the type to talk with your fists. What exactly do I look like to everyone else?" Cute. From what I understand, that term is used to describe small animals. Are you saying that I'm also being placed into that category? I am an anti-shadow weapon, but I don't seem to be regarded as such. I must correct this problem at once. If it is not addressed, it could negatively impact my ability to carry out my duties. Once I finish reading, I will start thinking of a solution. During combat, the mental states of both sides play a significant role in the outcome. I want my presence to strike fear in the hearts of my enemies, but galvanize my allies as well. What can I do to convey that kind of impression? Ideally, it would be something to encourage people to depend on me. Maybe I can find some tips in this book. This is enough reading for now. We should return to our rooms. Upgrade my outer appearance. First, I will triple the current surface area of my armor plating. After that, I will repaint my body gold and add a large dragon to my back. After reading this book, I came to a conclusion. This is what I have to do to appear strong and encourage people to depend on me. Outer appearances carry an influence that is beyond my ability to calculate. The main character of this story also carefully cultivated his image so everyone would take him seriously. That is why I'm looking into upgrading myself. In order for me to become more dependable, it's necessary I change my appearance. Don't you agree? Attitude? So that's what takes priority? Oh, could it be? I apologize. Please forget what I said about upgrading my appearance. It seems I had the completely wrong idea. At one point, the main character of the book says, "Can't have people think I ain't cool." Until then, he'd put so much effort into his attire, yet he goes to raid his rival's territory wearing nothing but a shimekomi. Thanks to you, I finally understand what's most important in life is having a strong heart to stay true to your beliefs. Therefore, I will also follow what I believe in. I may not appear dependable, but don't worry. I will adjust my attitude to reach maximum energy output and to increase my ammo stocks by 50%. For some reason, I feel like going to Tartarus and raising some hell. Shall we conduct a raid? Oh, it's gotten so late. It doesn't seem like we'll be able to go tonight. How unfortunate. I'll just return to my room then. Excuse me. Raids against our enemies is a highly efficient tactical strategy. It's almost bedtime. We should return to our rooms.